Oh man, I can't believe that. After all this freaking time, it was as simple as lighting some torches next to the fast travel point. I mean, I told you that because the treasure compass wasn't working, chances are it was a chest that was hidden behind some sort of like puzzle. You know, a chest that hadn't appeared yet. But I didn't know it was, I literally wasn't even, when I said, oh, I have one last place I want to check, I wasn't even meaning these. I meant I was going to look up here just to see double, triple, quadruple check and make sure there wasn't a chest tucked away in like a back corner somewhere. And I just saw these and I was like, oh, fine, I'll pop these three things. Why not? And then bam, there you go. So bound to still be chests out there, but at least the marker says 100% now, which is good enough for me. It's actually not good enough for me, because I would like it to be accurate, but at least it says 100%.
We're way behind schedule.
Okay, so I suppose we can continue. Wait, what is this dangerous? What? It said random event, and then I don't see it anywhere. Huh. Okay, whatever. Anyways. It wants me to wait 2 days. Time. Wait until what time? 8 to 10. 2 days later. Wait, what? I can't. Oh, I did. Okay. Is that count as 2 days? Fuck if I know, whatever, screw it. Got a new water. I actually had a piece of toast while I was... After that, in between the last episode and this episode. Because my tummy was really bothering me. Bloating. What the fuck? I got a huh? I got a login. Okay, I was looking. I like that, how I waited 2 days in game time and then the dailies reset at the same time. Did I just skip real life time? But I was looking at this, it hadn't, the weekly XP limit hadn't reset. Okay, so that means we can do our stuff, but I'm going to at least do the first part of this quest before we run off to do anything else.
Next on the agenda. Come on. No touching.
Did I start recording? Yeah, I did.
My experiment. Whatever would you do with it?
I'm gonna grab these berries. I don't know how many of these berry things I have, but... I'm gonna grab more. Okay. I didn't know if there was gonna be any slimes that would spawn. Ooh. Like stuff going on here.
Thank you, everyone, for your patience. I am pleased to announce that this year's Vinlesa Fest has officially begun. We hope the residents of Mondstadt and visitors from all over will enjoy the magnificent wines and experience the joy of the harvest. When Windcoming Day arrives, we will hold a grand toasting ceremony to welcome the Animo Archon Barbados back home.
No!
Let the wind lead!
Let the wind lead!
Razor, you're here already!
So many people.
I know, right?
Come on!
I do be like that sometimes.
There's someone we gotta find.
Find? Oh.
Just some tone-deaf bard. But he's also a know-it-all and loves nothing more than drinking, so he might actually be able to help.
Dude! Can I talk to everyone here? No, okay, I thought it... Okay, it's just this person.
Hey, Tone-Deaf Bard!
Traveler, Paimon, how do you do? I had a feeling I'd run into you soon, during this most enchanting of festivals.
Spoken like a true poet. But reading between the lines here, if one bottle is tipsy and two is merry, just how many is enchanting exactly?
Oh, don't say that. This festival has so much more to offer than just drinking. Anyway, hey Razor, how have you been?
All right.
Okay.
I have a question.
Yeah, Razor has something he wants to ask you about. Know anything about Thousand Wind Wine?
Ooh, now there's a name that takes me back. Let me think. How long has it been since I last heard someone mention Thousand Wind Wine?
Razor's parents left him a box with a half bottle of wine inside, and there's a label on it that says Thousand Wind Wine. We heard there's a lot of history behind this type of wine, and the brewing methods go way, way back. So we figured you'd be a good person to ask.
It smells good, but don't know what's inside.
I see. So you want to know how Thousand Wind Wine is made? Well, you came to the right person. I happen to know a little rhyme called, well, as it happens, Thousand Wind Wine. I was going to save it for Windcoming Day, but far be it from me to deny an early serenade to a friend in need. How about it? Shall I recite it for you?
A song, not easy to understand, but still want to hear.
Excellent answer. Then, hear it you shall. Fill up the barrels and store them away. Then wait for a windier day. Wax the bottles, seal them tight, for the south wind that soothes, for the north wind that bites. How does this fine wine taste
God,
to the tongue?
God, these suck
Has
so much.
To the ear, like a sweet dream of freedom. And what are the fruits that went into the brew? An explorer's courage, a love tender and true. A defender's will, strong as yesteryear, joining the thousand winds in a song of good cheer. Turning sour into sweet, bitter notes fade away as we wait for a windier day. thank you so much for the applause. Was the rhyme of help to you?
Like wine, a little sweet, but now head spinning. Don't understand.
Don't worry, it's not just you. That was supposed to be about winemaking, but it didn't give a single detail about the process.
Well, maybe it's a little abstract and romanticized, but that's one of the defining features of Mondstadt poetry.
Okay, so let's try to pin this down. What did the poem say the ingredients are? An explorer's courage, a love tender and true, a defender's will and the thousand winds? Song of good cheer? Nope, Paimon has absolutely no idea what any of these refer to. Look, Tone Deaf Bard, you clearly know what the whole thing means, so could you do us a favor and at least give us a hint?
You misunderstand me. I'm not trying to make you work for it or anything, but the lyrics are what they are. If there's anything they left out, even I can't fill in the blanks. If you want to know the secret behind this sweet scent, you might have to start by rolling up your sleeves.
Rolling up our sleeves? You mean, we need to go and make this wine for ourselves? And somehow that'll teach us everything we want to know? This better not be a prank!
We've known each other for so long, and you still don't trust my intentions? The pain!
I trust. I want to try. I want to make wine and find answers. If I know how to make wine, then I know what is in father and mother's wine. Right. I want to know about them.
Well, if you say so, Razor, guess we'll have to take Tone Deaf Bard's word on this one. We'll give it a try. And as first-time winemakers, there's no shame if it turns out bad.
Don't worry, really. Freedom is the key here.
What's Rosaria doing here?
You might think. As long as you add ingredients to the mix in a spirit of joy and sincerity, I promise you will reap the rewards you wish for.
I guess the church is helping.
I will tell poem to teacher. Then I need to think alone.
That's the spirit. So how about we meet again in 2 days?
Another 2 days.
Okay, same place, right here?
Okay, I will remember. See you then.
Act 1 completes. That's the first of the 3 quests. Oh, here we go. It's happening. Autumn Crisis. Secret Forest Shadow. Outside of Springvale, the hunter Edmund, who's busying himself with chasing forest boars away, is arguing with a young man who's dressed like a student from Sumeru. I get some rewards. High Wind Trial. Oh, it's the same rewards. Challenge event. Charity and Creativity. Okay.
Should we really be off work this early?
Let's go and browse while we still have the chance.
Try the best wine in town.
There's lots of people here to talk to. Oh, shit. I didn't want to get stuck in a fucking thing right now.
Wait! Honorary Knight! And Paimon, the best guide into that. I humbly beg for your assistance.
I was gonna bitch about that thing.
Wow. Did Paimon hear that right? Is Paimon finally starting to make a name for herself? Oh, wait. Haven't we met?
That's right. I'm Bernhard, a member of the logistics company under Captain Hertha. Normally, I would hope to become better acquainted before asking for a favor like this, but time's running out, so I really have no choice.
Well, what do you need?
Help me rescue the charity event.
Okay, this is for that charity event quest thing. I guess those are mini quests. I thought there'd be like activities, you know, where you earn primogems for whatever, like the Windbloom festival was that time.
The charity event? Oh, right! Master Jane mentioned that. So, what's happened?
Well, the Knights of Favonius wants to run a stall during the festival. The idea is for all profits from the sales to go to charity. Specifically, the funds will provide support to disadvantaged children and elderly citizens.
Oh, that's nice.
We drew lots to decide whose job it would be, and as it happened, I was the lucky winner. I really didn't want to screw this up, so I asked all around for advice, but My experience is in inventory and shipping. Now I'm supposed to run a whole shop, but it took me forever just to think of what to sell. I'm already completely out of my depth. And that is why I humbly beseech you to render your assistance.
Yeah! Also, no need to be so formal. So, you said this is to help out the kids and old folks of Mondstadt, right? Sounds like a great cause! She's an honorary knight, and Paimon's a longtime friend of Avonius! We'll be more than happy to do our part!
Oh, I can't thank you enough. Right, let me get down to brass tacks. Before we can open shop, we need to amass a supply of fair brew jellies. This is the basic currency that we will use when running the stall. The wine merchants in the area are in dire need of raw ingredients for winemaking. Sell them raw ingredients, and they will pay you generously in fair brew jellies. Also, there are some international customers looking to purchase beverages in bulk during the Vinlacefest period. They're on the market for an agent to handle their purchase orders. In the interest of establishing a long-term business relationship, these customers are usually willing to offer a generous price, and there's also room for negotiation with the wine merchants. The price difference is ours to keep as commission, and you can cash that amount in for fair brew jellies.
So to sum up, our job is to sell ingredients to the wine merchants and place orders for the international customers, making sure to negotiate the price, right? Huh. Sounds much easier than Paimon imagined.
Really? Well, that's wonderful. I have one order here with me already. Mr. Shavirme from Sumeru wishes to purchase 50 crates of Fruits of the Festival.
Damn.
These beverages can be bought from the Angel's Share stand. The shopkeeper's name is Georg.
Georg?
He's a very nice man, but he won't be pushed around. Please, consider the price carefully and try to reach a good deal with Georg.
Georg?
I should carry on setting up the stall now. Once you've gathered enough fair brew jellies, come back here and we'll take it from there.
Now,
you don't need to worry about supplies for the shop. I'm already in contact with the suppliers, and they'll send everything over once the funds are in place.
All right, sounds good. We'll find the funds and you sort out the shop.
This is an enormous help. Thank you both ever so much.
How many people in my comment section are named Georg? Let me see, does this have a listing? Oh, I've got some festive fervor. So... okay, it's just the next questy. Event details, can you... okay, it just shows me this. I don't understand, really? Just four... sub... quests with a few cards each? Huh. Okay. Well, I guess it's a thing. Right, and this is how you actually get that. But if you only get 50... hold on, if you only get 50 festive from that, and 50 from this, and assuming 50 from that, that's only going to be 150 festive fever when you need up to 1,000 in order to get all of the items. So there has to be an alternative way to earn it. So I'm guessing there's going to be more... let me get this charity event thing. Hello, Georg.
Hi there, Georg. We're Shavirme's agents. He's asked us to order 50 crates of Fruits of the Festival for him.
Oh? Did you say Shavirme? He's a regular customer of mine. Always orders around the same amount each time. But I digress. What price are you offering this year?
Oh boy. Oh fuck. So Georg won't be pushed around, I'm told. Well then let's offer him about 11,000... no. I don't know.
A little lower than I was hoping for, but he's a reliable customer. I think I can make it work.
Okay.
As usual, I will arrange for someone to deliver the goods directly to Shaverme's place of business. You won't have to worry about a thing. Just make sure you keep hold of this receipt.
All right, let's keep bringing the funds in. We gotta work quickly if we want to gather all these fair brew jellies in time. Bernhard says we can approach this however we want, just as long as we raise all the funds we need. We get a commission for every order we help place for an international customer. So maybe it's not worth trying to sell loads of ingredients to the wine merchants. Still, just to make sure we've covered everything, let's take a look at the other wine merchants.
Now what?
Traveler, Paimon, you're here!
What the fuck, Barbara? I'm trying to do wine selling.
Hey, it's Barbara!
Oh, wait, I don't have to click it.
Thanks, and happy Vine Lace Up Fest to you, too! This festival is one of the most popular ones in Mondstadt. I'm so happy I ran into you guys here. I hope you have a great time. Oh, also, I heard from Bernhard that you're collecting fair brew jellies.
Yeah, that's correct.
I'm just curious. Are you helping out with the Knights of Favonius charity event?
We sure are! Everybody's gotta do their part, right? The stall isn't up and running yet. We're busy raising funds so they can open for business. There's sure to be a bunch of other problems to deal with once it's open, but whatever comes up, we'll deal with it!
Wonderful! They're lucky to have you. Now that you've joined the team, I just know it'll be a huge success. I helped out a small charity sale for the Knights once too. Although, my only contribution was standing out front and singing. Oh, and I also met the bard, Venti, there. He even persuaded me to perform an impromptu song with him.
I highly doubt it.
The music he plays is quite refined and elegant. At first, I didn't want to sing too loudly in case I ruined the style he was going for.
Style my ass.
He sang a harmony to guide me in.
He didn't do
and
shit.
Before long, we were sounding great. In the end, the audience loved it, and we sold a lot at the event.
So Barbara's worked with the tone-deaf bard before?
You see, the thing I was saying earlier when I said, wow, these always suck, is because multiple times throughout this entire LP, Venti, or possibly another bard, but I'm pretty sure it's always been Venti, will always claim he's going to perform a song. He's a bard, after all. They tell stories in song. And every time, he just reads a poem off of a sheet of paper while doing, with his little instrument, ring, rung, and then that's it. It's the shittest fucking thing I've heard in the game. I mean, I'm not asking for, like, you know, a Nilo dance performance here. But I think they could put a little bit more effort into actually making it, you know, what they said it is.
Yeah. Too bad we couldn't fit it into the schedule this year. The Church of Favonius wants to hold a sung poetry event somewhere with a nice view during the festival, which means I have to go to rehearsal.
Yep. Sounds like we've each got our own important work to do. Let's give it our all!
Oh, thank you both. Well, maybe I can't stay here and sing, but I still want to do a little something to contribute. I can... I can help promote your stall. Should I make some big posters? Or maybe some flyers to hand out? I'll have to pick a memorable slogan, too. And maybe it'll seem more sincere if I sign them.
Ow, my neck.
Then again, maybe telling people in person would be more effective.
Wow! With Barbara helping out on the marketing side, this charity event will get lots more attention!
It's fine, really. It won't take me too long. Oh, now I feel a little embarrassed. Let me think about it a little more and talk to some other people about their marketing experience. Traveler, Paimon, I'll see you later. And, the Knights and the Church of Favonius are really proud of you.
Okay, thank you.
Aw, thanks! We'll do our best! Paimon's even more motivated than ever now. We gotta make sure we do a really great job here!
In charity and creativity, you must use the following two methods to gather enough funds before you open your charity shop. Sell winemaking ingredients to wine merchants, help out help other Outlander customers complete their orders, and collect service fees. What the fuck? Oh, maybe now it's opened up into an activity. I just had to do the quest to open it. Yeah, sure enough. Okay. Let's see, what is this? Get securing those funds. I need 32,000 shits. I have 3,175. Secure funds. Oh boy. Yeah, see, I get primogems and extra fever and stuff. Okay, so we've got complete the following proxy purchases or purchase requests to secure funds quickly. Purchase a batch of mint berries. I guess I can look at these in a moment. What is a managed shop? Oh, I can't do that, I guess, after 32,000 funds. Alright. Son of a bitch, dude. My freaking foot is caught on the goddamn blanket. I'm starting to panic. Okay. So let me see. Where are we at right here? In regards to the event. There's a girl up here. Should I try to look and see what she's into first? Temporary bartender for the cat's tail. She's the one that needs... Dude, look at the fucking... The board has cat ears on it. That's adorable. Oh my god. Oh my god. Like, guys, it's totally cute. Okay. Let me see. Let me go in... That's this girl here, right? That's just get in touch with the cat's tail. Purchase a batch of mint berries. So that would be from the cat's... So, mint berries. I guess I'm supposed to be talking to this lady for that. Do you have mint berries, Mr. Diane? Sorry, but Diona will be on leave for the duration of the festival. Oh, you're not here to see Diona? That's rare. Oh shit, I gotta change that.
Booze hounds.
I'd like to sell winemaking ingredients. Huh. So I actually have to sell my own ingredients here to get that. Well, hold on. Am I understanding this correctly? Oh, she's actually in Liyue Harbor. What the hell?
It's so nice to de-stress.
Oh, I was thinking, well, she said she needed stuff from the cat's tail, so I was like, oh, it's a cat's tail bartender person or whatever. Or stand-in. Well, fine. Then I will go to Liyue quick. See what I can do, because I don't want to go and sell my materials yet until I've done every other possible thing. So I'm pretty sure I've got plenty of materials to make the stuff I need. Hello there. Five cases of mint berries.
Hmm.
Okay, now I go back to Diane. Okay, so I did go to the right person. I just had to go and talk to this girl for her commission first. Okay, so her mood is pretty okay right now. It's good. I'm gonna try to go. Let's see how low she's willing to go. I doubt she'd go less than half the offer. Oh yeah, that killed her mood a lot. Please be reasonable. Okay, fine. Then how about the other way? Okay. So I guess I got on the low end of her spectrum, but at least we got the deal done. Beverage shop on the pure. Ooh. Okay, so I guess that has given me some extra... Yeah, that gave me some extra funds. I guess you get to keep a por- I guess I missed that detail, but I guess you keep some of a portion of the funds provided you when you're haggling with people. Okay, so... I might not need to sell my shit. I might just be able to get it all from these people. Okay, it looks like there's a few more. What is this one? I'm a chef currently staying in... Oh, no, not in that village. It's the one village. Pepper Village. Something that I must say interests me greatly. Could someone help me buy a batch of fruits of the festival? Don't worry, I know the rules. I'm commissioning people for an errand. You won't have to worry about payment. Okay, let me go to his village. Whoa, what is that taste that just overwhelmed my mouth? It's like a food. Like a sauce I just tasted. I don't know, is it like a marinara sauce or something? Had some phantom scents going on there. Hello there. $100 cases. Damn, how much is in a case? Yeah, keep the change. Okay. So that is how it works. It does sound kind of fun to manage a shop in this game, but we'll have to wait and see just how detailed it actually is. I have to come behind the counter. Oh, you're back. Yes, Georg. Alright, he did pretty well with me the other time. I think I can go ahead and maybe... How about we do this? Bum, bum, bum. Boo, boo, boo. I doubt you'll be here next time I come to give me some special drink. Oh, he just disappeared. Dong dong. Oh my god, okay. Alright, let me have a little peeksy around here. He didn't talk to that bartender. Where'd Venti run off to? Venti was standing there, and now he's gone. Oh, I guess I must have missed dialogue with him then, but... Let me see if there's anything that you can actually buy here.
Oh! Recipe!
Fruits of the festival, you better bet your frickin' ass I'm getting that. And there's all this other stuff. I don't know if you can get any of this stuff outside of the event, but I'm taking it. Fruits of the festival, that I guess is what I can make out of that thing. I will take that. Sparkling berry juice. It's got balls in it. Wolf hook juice, which I think is something we already have. Berry and mint burst, yes, yes, as I already own two of them. And apple cider, I don't own any of. Take that, thank you very much, sir. Okay, we'll talk to these other people as we go. Okay, so let me see what else is going on here. So there is also these two things. Angel Share's stall is buying brew ingredients. We have a large demand for ingredients and our prices are fair. The Cattail stall is now purchasing all... Okay, so I did the commissions and I guess now I have to make the rest on my own by farming ingredients. So let me see. How does that work? I'd rather sell to the kitty cat place. Because I'm biased towards cat. Okay, let me see. So, they will buy... It looks like they buy 5 at a time. But the price varies. I guess mint is the most common item, so... Snapdragon. It looks like dandelions. So that would be 10 then, right? Because it says 5. So I guess if it's a 2, then that means it's selling 10. And I need the 30... What? How much do I need? 32,000, I think? Let me just see. 3,000 earnings. Oh, you can only sell 5. It's not that it's 5 per. It's that I can only sell up to 5. I see. Well, then I might as well. Well, actually, let me sell what I have more of first. It's like, I suppose we can sell some of that. Yeah, fuck it. I might as well just sell all 5. Yeah, I guess it'll give you just enough, I'm sure. Maybe. We'll see if the stock is any different here. Okay, yeah, he takes, like, fruits and stuff. It's like berry. Valberry. Wolfhook and Valberry are really expensive, damn. I'll give him some sweet flowers, give him some sedias, some apples. And I guess we'll give him... What is that? That's 32,000 right there. Okay, that's what I need, right?
Yep, looks like we've got enough funds now. Let's go see Bernhard.
Okay, event details. Funds. Oh, we did it. 32,000 funds. So there's some of my extra rewards. Very nice. So now we've got manage shop. Oh, I see. I probably have to do a quest, I guess. Okay. Well, in that case, I will be right back before we go talk to Bernhard.